Up next, we've got John C. Dvorak and the doctor he's suing for malpractice.
John, I understand that you just went in for some routine surgery, and during the procedure, things went terribly awry. Now, why don't we just, before we get into that, let's back up a little bit, John, and why don't you tell us a little bit about the events leading up to...
Well, I was having some pain in my upper left abdomen, you see, and I went to my general practitioner, you know, and I said, hey, doc, I'm having some pain in my upper left abdomen, and he took one of those hammer things, you know, that you use on somebody's knee to test their reflexes. And he hammered away at it, at my abdomen for some reason. And then he said, John C. Dvorak, you've got what we call bad gallbladder stuff. Your gallbladder has all this stuff in it, you know, just gushing around in there. Foreign matter just gushing all over the place, gushing. So now we got to have it out. So I'm going to recommend this surgeon. You take it to him and he'll get it out of there.
And you were the surgeon he recommended.
Most people get their medical degrees from some sort of medical school, as you might well imagine. But mine was more of an honorary medical degree that the school awarded me for being such a faithful janitor for so many years. But here's what they didn't know. I wasn't a faithful janitor. I was carrying on a janitorial affair behind their backs. I was janiting for schools of higher learning, schools of lower learning, and every sort of learning in between. What this has to do with this boy's gallbladder is simply this. You can't sue somebody for malpractice when they ain't really practicing to begin with. You know what I'm saying?
So you went to this janitor who has an honorary medical degree to get your gallbladder out? That doesn't seem very wise.
No, it's not very wise, and if I had paid attention to his diploma up there on the wall, I would have seen that it wasn't a diploma at all, but like this really big coupon for pantyhose. Why would you frame a coupon for pantyhose? But, you know, it's my own damn fault, really. I should have done my homework. But I went to this guy. The first thing is, he doesn't give me anesthesia. He just sings me a lullaby to put me to sleep. Yeah. Well, that should have been my second clue. But I had the surgery. You know, I was asleep. He just operated on me. I woke up, and there I was, in the bed, in the recovery bed there, and I noticed something. Not only did I have my original gallbladder, but I had like all these extra gallbladders now undulating in there, going all these 17 gallbladders I had in there.
You know, just out of curiosity, I'd like to hear a couple of bars from the song that you put him to sleep with.
Hey, Paul, hey, Pedro, hey, fin de camino, hey, resto de toque, hey, poco cizeno, hey, caco de vidro, hey, vida y so, hey, noche moche, hey, lasse wozo, hey, perro a new campo, hey, no de madera, canga, candea, hey, machito pereira.
Hey, cut it out. I'm starting to get a little drowsy myself here. Starting to work on me. John, why don't you show us on the IBM PS2... what the doctor did to you.
First, his assistant took my head off, then he put his finger in my belly button, and then he gave my knees to his assistant. Then he took my skin off, and then you can see he took my tongue out there, and he tried to get my mouth off, but you know, the mouth is the hardest organ to remove here. Let me just get it out of there. There we go. Okay. Then he decides that he wants to get my ear close to his mouth. So he can sing to it some more. He sings, "Hey, my daddy, Gifento, Tombarari Vancera, El Misterio Profundo." By the way, this is a tool that he used to put more gallbladders in me. He put one there, put one there, put one there, three across the. Yep, there's another one. Everybody. Sing to me while I do this.
Suas aguas de mar, su fechando vero, el promeso de vida no te el carasel.
Right, that's some good singing. This is my liver that he took out. Then he put some gallbladders in my liver. Ah, screw it.
The sound the gallbladders made was more like
wasn't it more like
now, it's more like... undulating, you know, undulating, really just blah, blah, blah. So my liver's just out on the operating table, my ear's over here, I'm full of gallbladders, and he snaps his fingers and wakes me up in the middle of the operation. And I'm like, oh my God, help, 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 help.
Well, in my defense, you know, those gallbladders, I didn't put them in there on purpose. They were sitting up on my gallbladder shelf, and somebody pushed into the shelf, my gallbladder shelf, knocked all them gallbladders into his body cavity.
So rather than take them out, you just made them all permanent?
The real question you should be asking here is why I got a gallbladder shelf in my operating room to begin with. Hell, I don't know what I'm doing here. I ain't no surgeon. I just sewed them up on in there. The other thing I want to address is my giant-sized coupon for pantyhose that I had up on the wall. You know, when you find a good deal on pantyhose, you want to proclaim it to the world. Now, I should have just cashed that deal in, cashed the coupon in, but I got it
Let me stop you right there. You got your coupon framed for pantyhose instead of cashing it in.
You know, he never put my liver back in, so I'm just going to keep this liver and have some other doctor stick it in me. I got nothing left except gallbladders inside me. Yanked everything out and just put gallbladders in, but now I got a liver. I'm going to hire some doctor with a coupon for foot lotion to put it back in me, and then I'll have a liver, and I'll get him to take the gallbladders out, too. I don't need all these gallbladders, maybe a couple.
Listen, y'all just need to forget this whole episode ever happened. Just fall asleep and forget all about it. El Pau, El Pedra, El Fin de Camino, El Resto de Toco, El Poco
Cezinho,
El Caco de Vidro, El Videoso,
El Noche El Moche, El Lace Wazo, El Parobo No Campo, El No De Madera, Canga Candea, El Machita Pereira.